Good evening, this is Ganzonomy. Tonight's video will cover the Zeiss Ikon Box Tengor 56-2. The last of the Box Tengor series that was made by Guerriers from 1924 through 1926, and by Zeiss Ikon in various incarnations from 1926 through 1956. Some of the earlier incarnations had an F11 lens. This one has an F9 lens. I will go into greater detail on that later in the video. This is what's considered a box camera because, well, it looks like a box. It has a viewfinder over here and a viewfinder over there that work through a series of lenses and mirrors that are optimized for use when holding at waist level. This top lever here goes through your various focal lengths. You have 3 to 6 feet, 6 to 20 feet, and 20 feet to infinity. The bottom goes from F9, F11, and F16. What makes this a bit of an anomaly among box cameras is that it has far more user control than really any other box camera ever made. I'm going to set it to F9 for the time being. If we look at the side of this camera, what we see is the landscape viewfinder, the advanced dial, and the back release knob. Unlike many box cameras in which the dial is the release by pulling the dial out, this functions to release the dial back. So this would be pulled out and the back will come off. This is the shutter interlock. So if we have it at red and we switch it to white, the shutter is locked and will not function. This is the shutter release mechanism, and this is if you want to put an external shutter release onto this camera. Like I said, this is a very, very full-featured box camera, and many say it defeats the purpose of the simplicity of a box camera. But let's move on. The right side of the camera here, you have an external flash sync. You have the switch that sets between about a 1/30th of a second release, which is M, and then T mode by moving the switch up, which is better known as bulb mode to most of us. In essence, as long as you hold the shutter down, the shutter stays open and you can do long exposure. I'll put it back to instant for now because that's what I more frequently use. Up top here is the portrait viewfinder. A nice, I believe this is actual leather handle. And that's it for the back. On the back, you have a Zeiss Ikon logo. It says Germany down here. And to the left over here is a very interesting window. In most box cameras, this is an exposed red window. In high sunlight situations, it can be an area for light leaks. Zeiss, to their credit, made a little window that opens up, and now your red window is exposed, so you may see what exposure you're on. When you get to the next exposure, you close it back up to prevent light leaks. Very innovative, and I haven't seen it on any other box camera, so kudos. To open this camera, you simply pull out this knob here. It's going to be a bit difficult, but I will try. There we go. And you work the front part away from the back part, one way or another. So we'll just flip it up like this to make it easy. And yeah, you can tell this is a quality box camera. You need two hands to get it open. I'm not going to wrestle with it, so I'll be right back. So now we have it open. Up here is the spool. And if you notice this little white rectangle over here, when you advance the film, it becomes red. If this is red, and down here is red, then you are ready to take your exposure. I will get into that in a second. Back here is the 6x9 exposure size, and up here is your take-up spool. Your take-up spool is turned by that large knob. You would put the film on the bottom down here. You'd open this spring up carefully and put the film in here. You not only have this providing tension to hold your film in, but you also have a spring here to provide additional tension. Pretty much, this is very overbuilt for a box camera. I'll put it back together and go from there. So, in conclusion, this is right on the edge of what one could consider a box camera. Yes, it's shaped like a box, but it defeats in many ways the spirit of a box camera, which is supposed to be not only entry level, but cheap. The original Brownie was a cardboard box with a few pieces of metal and a basic meniscus lens. This is a metal box with variable focal lengths, variable aperture, two brilliant viewfinders with very large glass lenses and mirrors, and the piece de resistance, I would say, is the lens, which not only is it a meniscus lens, but it's an F9 achromat. That means two different types of glass with varying types of dispersion properties are used to reduce aberration and coma. Moreover, since this is a 1950s model, it's even coated. So it's very capable of sharp images, more in line with, say, a folding camera of the 50s, if not maybe a nice folding camera. Now, that being said, it is the entry-level Zeiss Ikon, so it's not really going to be as technical or as spectacularly sharp in many ways as, say, a medium format Tessar lens or a planner lens of the same era. But that being said, it's far superior in pretty much every way to every other box camera made. Unless, of course, what you want is a box camera. This is Ganzonomy. I hope you've enjoyed my video. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe, and have a great night.